In this video lecture for class 11, we are going to discuss how to find the dimensions of a physical quantity in terms of given quantities or given dimensions. Suppose, first I am taking very simple example that suppose force, its dimension is F. Velocity, its dimension is V. Okay, and time, its dimension I am taking T. These are the fundamental dimensions. Can we consider these as fundamental dimensions? Fundamental dimensions. Now, on basis of this, we have to find the dimension of mass. So, these things are given to us and we have to find the dimensions of mass. So, our first step is to find a formula between these physical quantities. And since we know that we have a basic formula for force, that is F is equal to ma. But still the problem is that the acceleration is not among the fundamental physical quantity. So this we can write as m, and in place of acceleration we can write velocity upon time. So we have the formula f is equal to mv upon t, and we have to find the dimensions of mass in terms of force given, velocity given, and time. So this is the required formula. Now we can write this formula as m is equal to f multiplied by t divided by v. Now we can directly write the dimensions of mass because these three are fundamental. So for force we have to write f, for time we have to write t, and for velocity we have to write v. So the dimensions of m is f to the power 1, t to the power 1, and this v when it comes in numerator. So this is our required dimension. So we are taking one more example of this, and that is a tricky question. First we have taken very simple question that you can understand. Now next we have, suppose we have some physical quantities. We have h, that is Planck's constant, capital G, universal gravitational constant, and we have c, speed of light. Okay, so the dimensional formula for speed of light, we know that L T minus 1. Okay? And G M minus 1 L 3 T minus 2. Okay? And H M L 2 T minus 1. So these are the dimensions. H is our Planck's constant, this one is gravitational constant, and this is speed of light. So these three are taken as fundamental dimensions. Now we have to find the dimensions of mass, length, and time. Okay, so this is the required condition. So we have to do certain settings. So first we can take, we can write h c upon g. Okay, h is Planck's constant, c is speed of light, and g is gravitational constant. Now we are going to write the dimension. minus 1 multiplied by the dimension of C, that is L T minus 1 divided by the dimensions of G, that is M minus 1 M minus 1 L 3 T minus 1. Now here if you see, this is L 2 and L 1, that becomes L to the power 3 and L to the power 3. So this gets cancelled here. T to the power minus 2 in numerator, T to the power minus 2 in denominator, that also gets cancelled. So we have H C upon G, that is equal to M square. Okay, or we can write this as M is equal to, here we can take the square root of these terms. So we have H to the power 1 by 2, C to the power 1 by 2 and G to the power minus 1 by 2. So these are the dimensions of mass. Here I am writing mass H to the power 1 by 2, C to the power 1 by 2 and G to the power minus 1 by 2. Okay. This we have calculated about mass. Next is we have length, that is length and time. Now second we can do the setting H upon C. So the dimensions of H is M L2 T minus 1 and here it is L T minus 1. So T minus 1, T minus 1 gets cancelled. Here 1 L and this L gets cancelled. So we have H upon C, that is equal to M L. And already we have calculated the dimensions of mass. So this we can write L is equal to H upon C multiplied by L. And we have to express the dimensions in terms of H, G and C. So H and C, we do not disturb these things and we have calculated the dimensions of M, that we will substitute here. So that is H upon C and in place of M we have H to the power 1 by 2, C to the power 1 by 2 and G to the power minus 1 by 2. Okay. Now when we solve it, here it can be written as H to the power 1 and H to the power minus 1 by 2 in numerator, C to the power minus 1, C to the power minus 1 by 2 and G to the power 1 by 2. Now we know that if the bases are same, exponents get added. So we have H power 1 minus 1 by 2. Similarly, here C to the power minus 1 minus 1 by 2 and G to the power 1 by 2 is there. So H to the power 2 minus 1 by 2, C to the power minus 2 minus 1 divided by 2 and G to the power 1 by 2. So we have the result. H is equal to 1 by 2, C to the power minus 3 by 2 and G to the power 1 by 2. So this is the required dimension of L. Okay, so I am writing here, it is H to the power 1 by 2, C to the power minus 3 by 2 and G to the power 1 by 2. Now one more dimension is left and that is of time. So for that we can directly use the dimensions of C. So C we can write L T minus 1 or we can write T C is equal to L upon T or T is equal to C L upon C. So the dimensions of L we have calculated H to the power 1 by 2, C to the power minus 3 by 2 and G to the power 1 by 2 and here we have C c power 1. So when we just change, solve this, we get x to the power 1 by 2, g to the power 1 by 2, and it becomes c to the power minus 3 by 2 and minus 1 in numerator. So this becomes c to the power minus 3 by 2, minus 3, minus 2 by 2. So that is c to the power minus 5 by 2. So here c to the power minus 5 by 2 is there. So this is the dimension of time. Now we have solved these type of questions. Now we have the idea how to change the dimensions of a physical quantity in terms of the other fundamental quantities which is given in the question.